Laudetur Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ. Welcome to St. Peter's Square once more for those of us who were with whom we were at the Holy Mass just ended. A very happy and blessed Easter to you wherever you are joining us from. It is Easter Sunday and Christ is truly risen. It's shortly before noon here in Rome, and soon Pope Francis will deliver the traditional message and impart on all of us the Urbi et Orbi blessing. The Holy Father Pope Francis just finished celebrating Easter Sunday Mass of the day here in St. Peter's Square, and then he went round the crowds greeting those within St. Peter's Square and many others flowing out into the streets nearby. On behalf of Vatican News, I would like to welcome all of you joining us for this live broadcast, viewers from around the world. A special word of welcome to those joining us, not forgetting our official partners of EWTN TV, Catholic Faith Network in America, Catholic TV, Salt and Light TV, Uganda Catholic Television, Shalom World Television Network in the USA, Shalom TV India, and Sunday Shalom at Madashan TV, and listeners of Sirius XM Radio New York, Luminous Radio India, Radio Maria PNG, and to the many of you joining us through our Vatican News channels, the Vatican News, Vatican Radio app, Vatican News English website, YouTube channel, our Facebook live feed, as well as those of you tuned in through the parish, diocesan, national Catholic radio and television stations across the world, including, of course, our shortwave radio listeners and other internet platforms. Welcome all. I'm Father Paul Samasumo, and it is indeed a privilege for me to provide you with today's texts and translations. What you are seeing now are the crowds in St. Peter's Square. They are happy to be here. It's Easter, and everybody wishing the Holy Father and wishing each other a happy Easter. One of the greatest moments, if not the greatest feast within the Christian's life. In just a few minutes, Pope Francis will deliver the Urbi et Orbi Easter Address and impart the Easter Apostolic Blessing on all of us. The Urbi et Orbi Address and Blessing is the most solemn form of blessing in the Catholic Church and is reserved for the most solemn occasions, usually Easter and Christmas, and on the proclamation, for example, of a newly elected Pope. There are one or two other occasions. Urbi et Orbi is Latin, literally meaning to the city and to the world. The world here referring to the papal blessing extending to the whole world, to all of us on this Easter Sunday. Earlier on during the Mass, I was speaking about the massive and the impressive decorations in St. Peter's Square, that is the courtyard just in front of the Basilica. Today, St. Peter's Square has been turned into a beautiful garden. The flowers are arranged as a befitting backdrop to the special day on this, the Resurrection Day of Christ. We have the florists to thank in the Netherlands. They have generously contributed these flowers. They are 35,000 flowers and plants all shipped from Holland to the Vatican. This is something that the Dutch florists have been doing for the last 39 years. The floral tribute started by the Dutch florists began in 1985. With the beatification of a Dutch Carmelite saint, St. Titus Brandsma. St. Titus was beatified in November 1985, and he was a martyr of faith, and he was then canonized a saint on 15th May 2022 by Pope Francis. The design of the floral arrangements in the square was put together by those who work in the Vatican Gardens and the Environmental Service of the Directory of Infrastructure of the Vatican City-State. All of this was done under the direction of Daniela Canu, who worked in collaboration with a Dutch florist and a group of biotechnology and floristry professors from Slovenia. No doubt their hard work is showing. On your screens, you can see we have the Swiss Guard, members of the Purple Swiss Guard, and a band, all in bright ceremonial attire. This is a special day. The guards are also wearing the 17th century armor to complement the gala uniform, complete with shiny helmet and red feathers. The Swiss Guards will play the national anthem of the Holy See today, and they'll be performing before the Holy Father. There is also a battalion from the Italian Armed Forces. They too are here with the band, and the Italian Armed Forces will also play the national anthem of Italy. Both the Swiss Guards, the Vatican Band, the Armed Forces, they'll be performing military honors just before the Urbi et Orbi blessing. Anytime we should see the Holy Father emerge from the balcony that is the central loggia up there, where you can see the banner hanging, the central loggia, the balcony of the central loggia in front of the Basilica of Saint Peter. And when the Pope emerges from there and looks down, he will find himself facing not only the crowds that are gathered here, but also a formation, as I have said, of the Pontifical Swiss Guards and a battalion representing the Italian Armed Forces. With the Urbi et Orbi blessing, Pope Francis will also grant a plenary indulgence to the faithful, that is, those of you who are watching or listening to this broadcast. We have the opportunity to receive an indulgence. An indulgence is not a quick ticket to heaven, as St. John Paul once said. It is an aid for the real conversion that leads to eternal happiness. An indulgence then is the result of the abundance of God's mercy, which he offers to humanity through Jesus Christ and through the Church. For us to receive this indulgence with a blessing, the reception of the indulgence therefore depends on one turning away from sin and converting. In other words, there are some conditions to receiving the indulgence. These include a spirit detached from sin, sacramental confession as soon as possible, at least within the next 20 days, Eucharistic communion, that is partaking in the Eucharist communion as soon as we have the opportunity, and praying for the intentions of the Holy Father. So we all receive the papal blessing with this Urbi et Orbi blessing, but also on top of that we have the opportunity to receive the indulgence, which is conditioned to detachment from sin, going to confession, receiving Holy Communion as soon as possible, and praying for the Holy Father's intentions. So you see now, right, the procession beginning, indicating the arrival of the Holy Father to start the Urbi et Orbi blessing. There are two cardinals who will be standing with the Holy Father. One is the Cardinal Protodeacon, who will introduce the blessings. Today the cardinals are Cardinal James Michael Harvey, the Archpriest of the Papal Basilica of St. Paul's Outside the Walls, and Cardinal Lorenzo Baldisseri. He is the Secretary General Emeritus of the Synod of Bishops. And as we said, the various formations of the Pontifical Swiss Guards and battalion representing the Italian armed forces are now performing before the Holy Father, and they will also play the Vatican National Anthem, the Holy See National Anthem, as well as the National Anthem of the of Italy, the Italian state. There's the Italian National Anthem. Some bars of the National Anthem there. Very impressive colors of the Swiss Guards, wearing their 17th century armor, shiny helmet and a feather, all on this special Easter day. The Lord is risen, the greatest feast for Christians. We now prepare ourselves to hear the Easter message from the Holy Spirit, from the Holy Father. Dear brothers and sisters, happy Easter. Today, throughout the world, there resounds the message proclaimed 2,000 years from Jerusalem. Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified, has been risen. The church relieves the amazement of the women who went to the tomb at dawn on the first day of the week. The tomb of Jesus had been sealed with a great stone. Today too, great stones, heavy stones, block the hopes of humanity. The stone of war, the stone of humanitarian crisis, the stone of human rights violations, the stone of human trafficking, and other stones as well. Like the women disciples of Jesus, we ask one another, who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb? This is the amazing discovery that the east of that Easter morning, the stone, the immense stone, was rolled away. The astonishment of the women is our astonishment as well. The tomb of Jesus is open and is empty. From this, everything begins anew. A new path leads through the empty tomb, the path that none of us but God alone could open, the path of life in the midst of death, the path of peace in the midst of war, the path of reconciliation in the midst of hatred, the path of fraternity in the midst of hostility.
Fratelli e sorelle,
brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen. He alone has the power to roll away the stone that block the path of life. He is the living one. He himself is the path. He is the way, the way that leads to life, the way of peace, reconciliation, and fraternity. He opens the path humanly impossible because only Him takes away the sin of the world and forgives our sins. For without God's forgiveness, that stone cannot be removed. Without the forgiveness of sins, there is no overcoming the barriers of prejudice, mutual recrimination, the presumption that we are always right and others wrong. Only the risen Christ, by granting us forgiveness of our sins, opens the way for a renewed world. Jesus alone opens us before the doors of life, those doors that we continuously shut with the war spreading throughout the world. Today, we want first and foremost to turn our eyes to the holy seat of Jerusalem, that witnessed the mystery of the passion, death, and resurrection of Jesus, and to all the Christian communities of the Holy Land. My thoughts go especially to the victims of the many conflicts throughout the world, beginning with those in Israel and Palestine and in Ukraine. May the risen Christ open the path of peace for the war-torn people of those regions. In calling for respect for the principles of international law, I express my hope for a general exchange of all prisoners between Russia and Ukraine, all for the sake of all. I appeal once again that access I appeal once again access to humanitarian aid be ensured to Gaza and call once more for the prompt release of the hostages seized on 7 October last and for an immediate ceasefire in the Strip. Let us not allow the current hostilities to continue to have grave repercussions on the civil populations, by now at the limit of its endurance, and above all on children. How much suffering we see in the eyes of these children. With those, they have forgotten how to smile. Those children in that area of war have forgotten how to smile. With those eyes, they ask us, why? Why all this death? Why all this destruction? War is always an absurdity and a defeat. Let us not allow the strengthening winds of war to blow on Europe and the Mediterranean. Let us not yield to the logic of weapons and rearming. Peace is never made with arms, but with outstretched hands and open hearts. Brothers and sisters, let us not forget Syria, which for 14 years has suffered from the effects of a long and devastating war. So many deaths and disappearances, so much poverty and destruction call for a response on the part of everyone and of the international community. My thoughts turn today in a special way to Lebanon, which has for some time experienced an institutional impasse and a deepening economic and social crisis, now aggravated by hostilities on the border with Israel. May the risen Lord comfort the beloved Lebanese people and sustain the entire country in its vocation to be a land of encounter, coexistence, and pluralism. I also think in particular of the region of the Western Balkans, where significant steps are being taken towards integration in the European project. May ethnic, cultural, and confessional differences be not a cause of division, but rather a source of enrichment for all of Europe and for the whole world. I likewise encourage the discussion taking place between Armenia and Azerbaijan so that with the support of the international community, they can pursue dialogue, assist the displaced, respect the places of worship of the various religious confessions, and arrive as soon as possible at a definite peace agreement. May the risen Christ open a path of hope to all those in other parts of the world are suffering from violence and conflict, food insecurity, and the effects of climate change. May He grant consolation to the victims of terrorism in all its forms. Let us pray for those who have lost their lives and implore their repentance and conversion for the perpetrators of these crimes. May the risen Lord assist the Haitian people so that there can soon be an end to the acts of violence, devastation, and bloodshed that in that country, and that they can advance to on the path of democracy and fraternity. May Christ grant consolation and strength to the Rohingya, beset by a great humanitarian crisis, and open the path of reconciliation to Myanmar, torn by years now by internal conflicts, so that every logic of violence may be definitely abandoned. May He open paths of peace on the African continent, especially on the suffering people in Sudan and in the entire region of the Sahel, in the Horn of Africa, in the region of Kivu, in the Democratic Republic of Congo, and in the province of Cabo Delgado in Mozambique, and bring an end to the prolonged situation of drought, which affects vast areas and provokes famine and hunger. May the risen one make the light on His face shine upon migrants and all those who are passing through a period of economic difficulties, and offer them consolation and hope in the moments of their needs. May Christ guide all persons of goodwill to unite themselves in solidarity in order to address together the many challenges which loom over the poorest families in search for a better life and happiness. On this day, we celebrate the life given us in the resurrection of the Son. Let us remember the infinite love of God for each one of us, a love that overcomes every limit and every weakness, and yet how much the precious gift of life is despised. How many children cannot even be born? How many die of hunger and are deprived of essential care, or are victims of abuse and violence? How many lives are made objects of trafficking for the increasing commerce of human beings? Brothers and sisters, on the day when Christ has set us free from slavery of death, I appeal to all who have political responsibilities to spare no efforts in combating the scourge of human trafficking by working tirelessly to dismantle the networks of exploitation and to bring freedom to those who are their victims. May the Lord comfort their families, above all those who are anxiously awaiting news of their loved ones, and ensure them comfort and hope. May the light of the resurrection illumine our minds and convert our hearts and make us aware of the value of every human life, which must be welcomed, protected, and loved. A happy Easter to all. Very powerful is the message there coming from Holy Father Pope Francis on this Easter day. And now we prepare to receive the blessing. The Cardinal Protodeacon announces the granting of the plenary indulgence.
Il Santo Padre Francesco.
His Holiness Pope Francis grants a plenary indulgence in the form laid down by the Church to all the faithful present here and those who receive these blessings by the radio, television, and the new communication media. Let us pray, ask the Almighty to grant the Pope many years and lead the Church and to peace and unity of Christ throughout the world. And now we prepare ourselves to receive the blessing and the indulgence. May the Holy Apostle Peter and Paul, in whose power and authority we trust, intercede for us and before the Lord. Through the prayers and merits of the Blessed Mary, our Virgin, Saint Michael, the Archangel Saint John and Baptist, and the Holy Apostle Peter and Paul and all the saints, the Almighty God have mercy on you and forgive all your sins, and may Jesus Christ bring you to everlasting life. May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant you indulgence, absolution, and the remission of all your sins, a season of true and fruitful penance, a well-deepened heart, amendment of life, the grace and comfort of all the Holy Spirit, and final perseverance in good works. And now the actual blessing itself.
Amen.
There we are. Having received the Urbi et Orbi blessing and indulgence. What a wonderful ceremony this has been, accompanied by a very, very powerful message from Pope Francis. Pope Francis now looking down to the courtyard. The Holy Father concluding the Urbi et Orbi. This also brings us to the end of this live world telecast. Thank you to Mondovision and some channels of Eurovision for joining us in this broadcast. Please do visit the Vatican News website, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube accounts. You will find photos, summaries of the Pope's homilies delivered during these special days leading to Easter. There is also playback of the liturgies that we have heard and covered in these days. On behalf of Vatican News, I would like to thank our in-studio technicians, our audio coordinators, and many technicians around the world who have made this transmission possible. And thank you to our media partners, EWTN TV, Catholic Faith Network in America, Catholic TV, Salt and Light TV, Uganda, Catholic Television, Shalom World Television Networks USA, Shalom TV India, and Sunday Shalom at Madashan TV, Sirius XM Radio New York, Luminous Radio India, Radio Maria PNG. Last but not least, thank you to you, our viewers and listeners, and on behalf of Vatican News, thank you to technicians, planners, broadcasters of the world Thank you, everyone. Happy Easter. Enjoy the rest of your day. Laudate Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ.